Are you hurting and broken within? Overwhelmed by the weight of your sin? Jesus is calling. Have you come to the end of yourself?
I'll prove. Hallelujah. The King of Glory, we bless you. The Lord of Lords, we give you praise. Yes, Lord, you are worthy. You are worthy to be praised. You are worthy to be honored. All glory belongs unto you, O Lord. There is none like you. Yes, Lord, we worship you. Yes, Lord, we exalt and adore your holy name. Yes, because you are the unchangeable changer. You are the miracle worker. You are the God, Almighty God. You speak and it comes to pass. You are incomparable. There is no one like you. Glory, glory, Hosanna be unto your holy name. You are the ever-living God. You are the faithful God. You are the mighty God. You are the God that never lost any battle. I worship you, Lord God, tonight. I exalt you for who you are. Glory, glory, glory be unto your holy name. In the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. You are welcome once more to our divine instruction, otherwise known as our Bible study time. Hallelujah. It's another time for us to learn at the feet of Jesus. The Almighty God is going to open his heavens over us tonight as we learn, you know, at his feet. Because the Bible says he is the greatest teacher. So he's going to teach us himself tonight. Don't bother about what you are seeing here, but just have your focus on God, because he is the one that will take over. He will teach and he will do what only he can do in our lives, in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. I welcome you once more again to this month of September. We have been taking a series of our lessons on fruitfulness and the increase, because this is our month of covenant of increase and fruitfulness. Hallelujah. And I pray as you journey with us, you know, on these topics, on these lessons, the Almighty God will visit you from heaven above with great fruitfulness, with mighty increase following, in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, ever-living God. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Hallelujah. Brethren, I just want you to lift up your voice. Just lift up your voice and begin to exalt this God. He deserves the praise. He deserves the glory. He deserves the honor. He deserves the adoration. Just lift up your voice. Forget where you are and just worship this God. Just worship the I am that is I am. Worship the lover of your soul. Give him all the praise. Give him all the glory. Give him all the honor. He deserves it, brethren. Ah, the mighty man in battle. Just worship him. Worship him anyhow you want to worship him. He deserves it. He deserves it. He's the great I am that is I am. He's the omnipotent God. He's the God of all flesh. The God that can do all things. He's the Alpha and he's the Omega. He's the beginning and the ending. Brethren, worship this God. Brethren, exalt this God. Come on, magnify him. Tell him, Daddy Lord Jehovah Shaddai, you are worthy. Tell him, Almighty God, you are worthy. Tell him, Almighty God, you are faithful. I have come to say thank you, Lord. I have come, oh Lord God, to worship you tonight. In the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, ever-living God. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. I want us to also lift up our voice and say, Father, Father, as I learn at your feet tonight, fill me with knowledge of your word. Fill me, O Lord, tonight with the knowledge of your word. In the mighty name of Jesus, Almighty God, as you teach, O Lord Jehovah Shaddai, yourself tonight. Ah, Daddy Lord God Jehovah, fill me, O Lord. Fill me with the knowledge of your word, Almighty God. In the mighty name of Jesus, Almighty God, grant unto me spiritual understanding of your word. Grant unto me, O Lord God, spiritual understanding of your word. In the mighty name of Jesus, Jehovah Shaddai, grant unto me, O Lord God. Tell God to grant unto you spiritual understanding. You need to understand his word so that you'll be able to walk perfectly in his will. Say, Father, Lord, grant unto me spiritual understanding of your word tonight. In the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Abba Father. In Jesus' matchless name, we have prayed. Hallelujah. Come and give a shout of hallelujah to the Almighty God. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. We have been looking, as I said before, the series of covenant of increase and fruitfulness, as this is our anchor topic for this month of September, a month of increase, a month of fruitfulness. And the first lesson that was taken was understanding godly principles for increase. We were taught about the godly principles for increase. And the second topic that followed was steps to increase. And the next one was hindrances to increase. Hallelujah. And by the grace of God, today we are going into a new topic, which says sustaining increase. Amen. And I'm taking my Bible text from the book of Psalm 67, 5 to 7. Psalm 67 from verse 5 to 7. It says, let the people praise thee, O God. Let all the people praise thee. 6, then shall the earth yield her increase. And God, even our own God, shall bless us. God shall bless us, and all the ends of the earth shall fear him. Hallelujah. Brethren, this place is telling us to praise God. He said, let us praise God. That when we praise God, even the earth, that time the earth will yield and increase, and God will bless us. And when God blesses us, he blesses us with increase. And when we will get this increase, we want to look, how do we sustain it? Hallelujah. Brethren, you have to be fruitful before you can increase. You have to be fruitful before you can increase. In other words, there can not be increase except you are fruitful. There cannot be increase except you are fruitful. And you cannot experience fruitfulness without sowing a seed. You cannot experience fruitfulness without sowing a seed. This seed needs to be sown on a good soil, because the soil that you sow your seed determines the fruit you get. The soil you sow your seed on, it determines the kind of fruit you get. It determines, you know, the feedback you get. Hallelujah. Let's quickly open our books to the book of Matthew chapter 13 from verse 3 to 8. Matthew chapter 13 from verse 3 to 8. And I read, and he spake many things unto them in parables, saying, behold, a sower went forth to sow, and when he sowed, some seed fell by the wayside. The fowls came, devoured them up. Some fell upon stony places, where they had not much earth, and forthwith they sprung up, because they had no deepness of earth. 6, and when the sun was up, they were scorched, and because they had no root, they withered away. 7, and some fell among thorns, and the thorns sprung up and choked them. Verse 8, it says, but others fell into good ground and brought forth fruit, some 100-fold, some 60-fold, some 30-fold. Hallelujah. Can you see what I'm saying? Your seed have to fall, you know, on a good soil. You will see that the story we have read of the parable of the sower, we have some that fell by the wayside, they did not survive. Some fell on the stony places, they could not survive. Even some fell among thorns, and the thorns did what? It sprung up and choked them. Hallelujah. But in verse 8, we will see that he said, this seed, they fell on good ground, they fell into good soil, and they brought forth fruit, some 100-fold, some 60-fold, and some 30-fold. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. And this shows there was multiplication and there was an increase. According to that verse 8, it was multiplication. Because when it fell there, it came up 100-fold, 60-fold, and 30-fold. There was increase. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Brethren, increase comes in various forms. We have spiritual increase. We have physical increase. We have material increase. We have financial increase. Even we have academical increase. We have career increase. We have a professional increase. There are increase in all ramifications of a life. Hallelujah. Then, if the Lord blesses us according to our test, If the Lord blesses us and increases us in all ramifications of life, how can you maintain this increase? That is what we want to look at. How do you maintain, or how can you maintain this increase? How can you keep up this increase? How can you continue with this increase? How can you preserve this increase? How can you retain this increase? This will bring us to our topic of today, sustaining increase. Brethren, we want to look at how we can sustain this increase we have been talking about. We want to look at how we can, you know, make sure we are still in that position of increase that our fruitfulness has brought. Amen. Hallelujah. The first point I wrote down here that can help us to sustain our increase is that you must make the right connection. You must have the right connection. You must be correctly connected to the source, to the root. If you want to sustain your increase, that means there is somebody that is in charge of increase. Amen. There is somebody in charge of increase. You have to be connected to that person. You must make that right connection. Hallelujah. The book of John 15 and verse 1. John 15 and verse 1. He said, I am the true vine, and my Father is the husbandman. Jesus is the genuine vine. He is the only real source of eternal, abundant, and fruitful life. He goes on to say in verse 5, I am the vine. You are the branches. Without me, you can do nothing. Amen. But this doesn't really literally mean, no, we can't do anything at all. But it does mean that apart from Christ, we cannot produce a fruitful life. Apart from Christ, it's not possible for us to produce a fruitful life. We are not independent, but we are completely dependent on Him to produce fruit and to retain it. We are completely dependent on Him. Amen. So that is why you must make the right connection. You must have the right relationship. Who are you relating with? It will determine if your increase will be sustained or not. It's just like, you know, knowing that this person is in charge of giving out, maybe peradventure you want to collect loan, maybe in the bank. This person is the person in charge of loan. And you are going to meet the other person. It's not possible. It's not possible. You need to have the right connection to the person that does what? That gives increase. The one that gives increase, when you are connected with him, when you have a relationship with him, then he will be able to help you sustain it because it belongs to him, because he's the one in charge, because he's the originator. Amen. Hallelujah. Here we go to the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 3 and verse 6. 1 Corinthians chapter 3 and verse 6. Apostle Paul said, I have planted, Apollos watered, but God gave the increase. Brethren, it's God that gives increase. So you have to be rightly connected to him. If you want to sustain your increase, you have to be connected to the God of increase. You have to be connected to the God of increase. And if we look at that same book of John 15 and verse 4, he said, abide in me and I in you. As the branch cannot bear fruit of itself, except it abide in the vine, no more can ye, except ye abide in me. Brethren, you cannot enjoy a life of increase unless you make your home in Christ. Unless you make your home in Christ, you abide in him and let it abide in you. Amen. That is the way that you will be able to do what? To sustain, you know, retain your increase. Amen. Basically, Jesus says, if you want to experience a fruitful life, you have to get, you know, connected to him. You have to draw, you know, your life and strength from him. As a branch draws life and strength from the vine. Amen. So you need to abide in Christ. And abiding in Christ means you are continually living in his presence. That relationship is a continuous one. It's not the one you have today and you go out of it tomorrow. No, it's a continuous relationship. Continuously, you are in his presence. And when you are, when you abide with him, then he will be able to do what? To sustain this increase we are talking about. Because it's like you have already invited him. You are abiding in him, he's abiding, he's also in you. Praise the Lord. How will you not, you know, you will leave the one that brings about increase? You can hear what Apostle Paul said in that passage we read in 1 Corinthians 3. He said, it's God that gives the increase. I did my own. Apollos did his own. Then God gave the increase. So if he's the one that gives the increase, let us abide in him. If we abide in him, he too will abide in us. And we will be able to sustain, because he's the one that owns it. He will be able to help us to sustain that increase. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Abide with him the way a branch clings to and draw life and strength from the vine. That's the same way you need to abide with him. Abide with the God of increase. Abide with him, because increase belongs to him. He's the one that gives increase. It comes from nowhere. It doesn't come from the north, south, east, or west. It comes from God Almighty. All we have to do, you do your own and let him give the increase. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. The second point here is that you need to employ the power of prayers. You need to employ the power of prayers. When you use prayers to keep. You use prayers to do what? To protect. To protect your increase. Brethren, as the saying goes, prayer is the key. Prayer is the key that can open. Prayer is the key that can lock. Amen. When you use prayers, you know, you release prayers upon your increase, you will see that your increase will be going in leaps and bounds. Because even in the book of 1 John chapter 5 and verse 14, he said, now this is the confidence that we have in him, that if we ask anything according to his will, he heareth us. He heareth us. So if you pray, you are praying according to the will of God, that you want to retain your increase, he will hear you. So that is why we need to pray. We need to employ that power of prayers. Brethren, without prayers, there is nothing good that we still remain good without prayers. But when you bring prayer in, it is only prayers that can make the difference. Prayer makes the difference. Because as a Christian, when you pray, truly desiring the will of God, that prayers, you know, has incredible power to bring about what you are praying for. Amen. So we need to employ the power of prayers to be able to sustain our increase. Hallelujah. It's prayers that even brought it. Because when you sow seed, I'm very sure you did not go and sleep that seed, okay, let it be there. No. I'm sure you were praying, Father, make this my seed. Let it be fruitful. Let it produce very well. Prayer brought it, and prayer will sustain it. Hallelujah. So that is why we need to employ the power of prayers. Amen. Hallelujah. Another point I have here is obedience to the word of God. Obedience to the word of God. My brothers and my sisters, we need to obey the word of God if we want our increase, you know, to be retained. Because you cannot be disobedient to the God of increase, to the God that gave you that increase, and, you know, you still want him to increase that, you still want him to sustain that increase for you. It's not possible. Psalm 1, verse 2 to 3. He said, but his delight is in the law of the Lord. Whose delight? The delight of the child of God is in the law of the Lord, and in his law doeth he meditate day and night. And when he delights in this law, when he obeys this law, what happens? You see, and he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that bringeth forth its fruit in its season. His leaf also shall not wither, and whatsoever he doeth shall prosper. Hallelujah. Brethren, that is what obedience is. Obedience is the means that God uses to, you know, he bestows his love and blessing upon us. Hallelujah. It's a way for Christians to be nourished. It's a way for Christians to be nourished by obeying the word of God. Because the word of God is our pathfinder. The word of God is that word that shows us the right path, the right way. And you are obeying it. You can see what the psalmist said here. Anybody that delights, you obey the word of God. He said, it shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water. The fruit, you know, we come forth in its season. There's no delay. Its leaf will not wither. And whatsoever that person shall do, we prosper. So as you obey, whatsoever you do, when you become fruitful, increase will definitely follow. Hallelujah. When the word of God abides in a believer, it becomes an integral part of that person's life. Jesus compared it to the foundation of a house. He compared it to the foundation of a house. Without the foundation, the house cannot stand against the natural force. Cannot stand against the natural forces of wind. It cannot stand against the natural forces of rain and flood. Matthew 7, 24 to 27. Matthew chapter 7, 24 to 27. You will get that story there. When the foundation, you know, cannot stand, then that means that that house cannot even stand at all. The house depends upon the foundation for support in time of need. Brethren, that is how your obedience is a foundation for you to support. It's a foundation that stands as a support for you in time of need when you want God to intervene in your increase. Because by the time you obey God, this obedience stands as a support for you. It stands as a foundation for the support that you need from God. You see, for the word of God to be foundational in your life, you must do what the word says. Obeying the word in season and out of season. So if you want your increase to be sustained, or you want it to be retained, or you want to maintain your increase, then you have to obey the word of God. You have to obey the word of God. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. We need that obedience as children of God. We need it, you know, as something that will help us, will give us a foundation that God can work upon for us, that can support God to work for us, that can support God to sustain that increase, that can support God to retain, to maintain that increase for us. Amen. Hallelujah. Another point here again is eliminate the weeds in your life. Eliminate those things, you know, that will make God not to intervene, that will make God not to look unto you, that will make God not to answer your prayers when you call upon him. You have to eliminate them. You have to kill them. You have to let them go. You have to bury them. Hallelujah. If we look at the book of Luke 8 and 14, Luke 8 and verse 14, and that which fell among thorns are they which, when they have heard, go forth and are choked with cares and riches, pleasures of this life, and bring no fruit to perfection. And some other version says, and their fruit never ripens. Brethren, when your fruit does not ripe, That is, you did not get a good harvest. Then how do you want to get increase? How does increase now come? Amen. So you need to remove all those things that will not make your increase to be, that will not make your fruit to produce very well. You need to remove them. Remove those things. Weed them away from your life. Those things that choke, you know, the word of God, that choke the way you relate with God, the cares of this world, riches and pleasures. Eliminate them. If we want to look at these examples of weeds, we can see that in the book of Luke chapter 14. Luke chapter 14. Hallelujah. Luke chapter 14 from verse 16 to 20. Then said he unto him, a certain man made a great supper and bade many, and sent a servant at supper time to say to them that we are bidding, come, for all things are now ready. 18. And they all with one consent began to make excuses. They began to make excuses. Whatever we make you to begin to make excuses that we make your increase, you know, not to be retained, I pray the Almighty God will separate you from it in the name of Jesus. The first said unto him, I have got a piece of land, the cares of this world. Hallelujah. The things of the world. Amen. I have bought a piece of ground, and I must needs go and see it. I pray thee have me excused. 19. And another said, I have bought 5 yokes of oxen, and I go to prove them. I pray thee have me excused. And another said, I have married a wife, and therefore I cannot come. Brethren, the cares of this world, greed, relationship, career, what are those things that are creeping into your life? This is the time. Get rid of them. Eliminate them so that you will be able to retain, so that you will be able to maintain your increase. So you will have to eliminate those weeds in your life. You have to eliminate those things that will not make you to be able, you know, to be in good accord or to be in good alignment with your God, for him to be able, you know, to look upon you when you call upon him to sustain your increase. Hallelujah. We have to leave the world. You cannot be neither here nor there. You have to take a stand. That is why you're taking a stand means you have to eliminate those weeds. You have to eliminate them. Let them go. Let them go. Let them go, brethren. Let them go. So that these blessings of God, so that this increase of God will be sustained. And I pray the Almighty God will help us to eliminate these seeds. It will help us to destroy all those things that will not make God help us to sustain our increase. Another point here is put your trust and confidence in God. Brethren, you need to put your trust. You need to put your confidence in God. Because the Bible says those that put their trust in God, they will not be put to shame. He said, those that put their trust in God will not be put to shame. Let's quickly open our Bibles to the book of Jeremiah 17 from verse 7 to 8. Jeremiah 17, 7 to 8. He said, blessed is the man that trusted in the Lord and whose hope the Lord is. Blessed is the man that trusted in the Lord. You are blessed already when your trust is in God and your confidence, your hope is in the Lord. Verse 8 says, for he shall be a tree planted by the waters, and that spreadeth out a root by the river, and shall not see when heat cometh. When heat come, you don't have anything to do with it. But a leaf shall be green, and shall not be careful in the year of drought. You don't have anything to do with drought. Drought will not be your business, because you put your trust and your confidence in the God of increase. Your confidence is in the God of increase. So when your confidence and your trust is in the God of increase, he will do what only he can do. He will do what only he can do. As he said, neither shall cease from yielding fruit. So when you put your trust in the Lord, you will not cease yielding fruit. And if you don't cease yielding fruit, that means fruitfulness is something sure it will come. And when you are fruitful, you increase. When that fruitfulness come, increase will follow. Hallelujah. So if you want your increase to be sustained, you want it to be retained, you want it to be maintained, to be preserved, then you need to trust God. You trust this God of increase and confident, you put your confidence in him. He's the only one. He's the only one, brother. He's the only one, my sister, that can do it for us. No man can give you increase if not God Almighty. Amen. Another point here is that for you to sustain your increase, you need the spirit of humility. You need what? The spirit of humility. Because the book of Proverbs chapter 3 and verse 34. Proverbs chapter 3 and verse 34. He says, surely he scorns the scornful. He scorns the scornful. But he gives grace to the humble. He gives grace to the humble. And in the same Bible, in the book of 1 Peter chapter 5 and verse 5b, he says, and be clothed with humility. Be clothed with humility. Brethren, humility has a cloth. Put it on. Put it on. Because God resists the proud. God resists the proud, but gives grace to the humble. And when God resists the proud, you can no longer have increase or become fruitful. So what follows will be stagnation. Hallelujah. You need humility, you know, for God to intervene to help you sustain this increase we are talking about. You need God. Because by the time you are proud, the Bible says he resists the proud. It doesn't have anything to do with the proud. So when he resists you, you can no longer increase and there will be stagnation. I pray stagnation will not be, it will not be your portion in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Let's quickly open our Bibles to the book of 1 Timothy chapter 6 and verse 17. 1 Timothy chapter 6 and verse 17. He said, charge them that are rich in this world, that they be not high-minded. Let them not be proud, nor trust in uncertain riches, but in the living God, who giveth us richly all things to enjoy. As many, you know, they are flourishing, they have this fruitfulness, they have this increase. The Bible is warning us that we should not be high-minded. We should not bring in pride. Remove pride. Remove pride. And instead, give God, you know, give God all the praise, trust God, because he's the one that giveth us, you know, riches in all things we do. He's the one that giveth us riches. Riches come from him. He's the one that blesses us. So that increase you have, for you to sustain it, for you to maintain it, you need the spirit of humility. My brother, you need the spirit of humility because God resists the proud. He does not have anything. So if you are proud, he will not come in. You can't call him and he will come because he doesn't have anything to do with the, he resists the proud. He resists them. He resists them. So that is why we need the spirit of humility to be able to sustain our increase. Amen. Hallelujah. Then, the last point here is sow continuously. Brethren, you want to sustain your increase? Then sow continuously. Hallelujah. By the time you stop sowing, that means you will not reap. And when you don't reap, you will not be fruitful. And when you are not fruitful, you will not increase. So you need to sow continuously. Don't stop sowing, because it is through sowing that you have fruitful harvest of increase. It's true, you know, your sowing that you have fruitful harvest of increase. Ecclesiastes chapter 11 and verse 6. Ecclesiastes chapter 11 and verse 6. Amen. It says, in the morning, sow thy seed, and in the evening, withhold not thy hand, for thou knowest not whether shall prosper either this or that, or whether they both shall be alike good. Amen. Brethren, you need to sow every opportunity you have to sow. Sow. Look at what the preacher is saying here. He says, sow in the morning, sow in the evening, sow anytime, sow in the afternoon. Continuously sow. Continuously sow. Sow continuously. Don't give up on sowing. Any opportunity you have to sow, sow. Sow on good soil. And you'll see God helping you to sustain, to maintain that increase. Because where you did not sow, how do you want to reap? The Bible says, whatsoever a man sows, that is what he will reap. So when you did not sow anything, what do you want to reap? What do you now want to reap? So you have to continuously sow, as the preacher have said here. Sow in the morning, brethren. Even sow in the noontime. Sow in the nighttime. Sow in the evening time. Sow anytime you have the opportunity to sow. Sow. And the Almighty God will do what? Will continuously give you increase. If you desire a continuous, you know, increase in your life, the thing that is very sure for you to do is you have to sow. You have to sow. I pray the grace to be able to sow. The Almighty God will release upon us in the mighty name of Jesus. Brethren, there are various seeds we can sow. Various seeds we can sow that can give us, you know, increase. We can sow spiritual seed. We can sow financial seed. We can sow seed of love. We can sow eternal seed. We can different seed. Sow this seed, but let them be on good soil. And as you do this, the Almighty God will bless you in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. In conclusion, be connected. Stay connected and remain with the God of increase. And he will increase you in all areas of your life in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. Brethren, I want to thank you for being part of this teaching tonight. Just let us bow down our head and begin to appreciate this God. Say, Father, I thank you. Almighty God, I bless you for filling me tonight with the knowledge of your word, for filling me tonight, for me to know how I'll be able to sustain this increase. So that this increase, oh Lord, I will not lose it. Father, I thank you. Jehovah God, I bless you. Be thou glorified in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. You are going to lift up your voices again and say, Father, Father, I have heard your word tonight. I have seen how I'll be able to sustain, Almighty God, my increase. The grace, oh Lord, the grace to do these words, the grace to obey this word, Almighty God, release upon me. The grace, oh Lord, to be Almighty God connected to you, release upon me. The grace, oh Lord, to sow continuously, release upon me. That grace to obey you, release upon me. Make me, oh Lord God, not to be hearers of your word only, but help me to be doers of your word. There must be a difference, Almighty God, in my life this season, in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Almighty God. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Hallelujah. Brethren, it will be streaming on the screen. Please, give your offering for what the Lord has done. Give your offering. It's a privilege for you to give unto the Lord. So count it as a privilege and give something to God. Even as the bank details is being streamed on our screen right now. And as you do this, the Almighty God will bless you richly in the mighty name of Jesus. I believe you have been blessed. I believe the Lord has spoken a word into your life. Hold on to that word. It's going to perform a miracle. It's going to perform signs and wonders. And you will come back to testify to the glory of the Almighty God. May the Almighty God bless you. As you join us again next week, same time, stay blessed. In Jesus' name, hallelujah, amen.